We now head over to Western Uganda, where over 1,000 individuals are likely to face forcible evictions from their homes in over 14 districts near River Rizi. This is an effort by government to conserve one of the biggest water catchment areas in Western Uganda. Construction of property worth billions of shillings is likely to be demolished, and environmental authorities say that the restoration of a depleting river, which is River Rizi, and its adjacent ecosystem will not be negotiable. We have more on this story.
Sylvia Ainebiona is a resident in Kakoba Division, Barra City. She is among tens of thousands of residents living along the catchment zone of River Rizi, waiting to be expelled by environment authorities.
What hurts us most is that we bought the land long time ago and no one, even NEMA, came to dispute that it was a catchment zone of the river. Some of us have lived here for more than two decades. The government should consider and bail us because we cannot afford to lose our property.
Her story is no different from that of Nelson Tayewa, who owns 4 acres of land in the same area.
They told us that we have to reserve 30 meters from the river banks, but now NEMA wants 100 meters. That affects all our investments. We need government intervention.
Environment authorities say by all means they have to save River Rizi, that is currently its only source of water to thousands of people in Ankole and beyond.
We shall serve each individual in his capacity what we call environmental restoration order. The environmental restoration order is a court order of High Court. So you read the violation you did and what you are supposed to do to rectify the violation. And once you don't want, you fail to comply after the expiration of the restoration order, now for us we move in. And the cost that we incur in a demolition will be posted on your account.
National Environment Management Authority also faults Barra City authorities for issuing illegal construction plans to most degraders, a statement they have refuted.
When we set the law of the environment management, it is very clear. Environmental management was fully decentralized. Now the blame is for urban authority. Because you cannot set up any structure in urban without approval. The one whom they should be crying foul with is the urban authority. But we shall not see the river almost getting extinct with those people who are sitting on the river banks.
Some leaders have asked government to consider compensation of all communities along the river banks, as many are battling government in court.
We have people who have constructed houses in the buffer zone near our River Rizi here. This River Rizi is the blood of the city. We can't have a city, we can't live without water. These people should live. I support them to live. But how should they? Where should they go? I think they should be compensated. We should talk to the government so that these people are compensated, and then we see how they can move to other places.
The National Environment Act, enacted in 1995 Constitution, provides for conservation and management of natural resources. Therefore, all land titles acquired next to the law are unlawful. Story compiled by Damba Weasley for the news in Barra.